If you were to ask yourself the question, who am I? It's not an easy question to answer, is it? And that's because in our mind, the idea of who we are and who we think we are is a construct of all of our past experiences, the memories, the belief patterns, the experiences and things we've done in our life, the skills we've learned, the challenges we've faced, our personality type. And we bring all of these things together and we call it an identity. Now, in your past, if you go back to when you were a kid, maybe you had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or even more identities. And maybe you'd blend in and be like a chameleon, just like I was, where you'd have different friend groups and you'd try and fit in, and it's all for different reasons. You see, when it comes to lasting change and creating big transformation in your life, what I've come to realize in my own journey, from my own experience, is that identity shifting is the key piece. A few years ago, I read this particular book by Lewis Howes, The Mask of Masculinity. Now, this book resonated with me a lot because Lewis talks about several masks that you wear, especially as a guy growing up. And I'm sure it's the same for women too. But there were a couple of masks in particular that resonated a lot with me when I was younger. One of them being the Joker mask. Now, I wore this mask, or identity as you call it, because for me, in certain parts of my life, that's how I wanted to fit in. That was my way of avoiding being bullied, of trying to get along with more people. And I'd blend in. I didn't like conflict. I didn't like discomfort. And so I would do whatever I could to adapt to the situation, which is pretty normal. And so identity shifting is really looking about the person that you want to become, seeing where you are now and seeing what you need to change, and then shifting into that new person and acting from that place. Now, as many people do, I had my challenges growing up. There was family issues at home. I was a very shy person. I lacked confidence. I felt skinny. I thought girls weren't into me. I was worried about how I was doing in school and how people perceived me. I thought I was maybe dumb. And all of these things affected who I was as a person, and it kind of carved my identity. And then, so as you get a little bit older, this forms your experiences in life, because ultimately what happens is it creates beliefs in you. It creates deeply rooted programming, which is influenced from a young age. So up until about the age of 7, you're very influenced by your surroundings, what you get told, the information that comes in here, and we start to fit in and see, who am I in this world? Where do I fit in? What's my identity? How can I get along safely? How can I find my place and move forwards in life? And so then when we fast forward to the present moment and we're looking at our lives and we're looking at things that we want to change, do you want a better relationship? You want to change your body? You want more money? You want to start a business? Or whatever that thing is, it ultimately comes down to changing your identity. And most people go wrong because what they're trying to do is they're setting goals out in the future. They're trying to change specific things about themselves or in their life, but they're not understanding the identity piece, which is the root of this. Now, identity is spoken about by many respectable people in the self-development industry. Dr. Joe Dispenza has a book called Breaking the Habit of Being Yourself, which is a great book. There's Psycho-Cybernetics by Maxwell Maltz, which is one of the classic self-help books on self-image and creating a new version of yourself. Tony Robbins talks a lot about identity, and Ed Milet, who I follow. And so there's lots of experts and professionals talking about this type of stuff because it's so, so important to lasting change. And with my own experience of working with clients, helping them in transformation and changing themselves, identity has always been the big piece that comes up and holds people back. So some of the ways that this is going to hold people back is really beliefs. Now, if you want to learn more about how to change your beliefs, I've created a video. I'll leave a link there where you should watch that one. Definitely check it out. And you can also download my free belief blueprint, which I'll leave a link below this video. You see, your beliefs are very closely linked to your actions and your behaviors. Your beliefs will drive your actions. And so your beliefs are something that you must address. These are going to hold you back. These are the stories that you tell yourself. Maybe when you were younger, there were certain beliefs you had that are no longer true, that no longer serve you. And it's time to let go of them. If you want to create a new identity, it's about letting go of the past. It's about creating the new version of yourself. The other huge challenge I see that comes into the topic of identity shifting and making lasting change, and this has been a big one for me personally, and that's this idea of other people that you know, that you grew up with, that you're surrounded by, that know who you are, and you're trying to change who you are. There's this kind of internal belief or this attachment to the old version of you. There's this huge desire that's coming up inside. You know you want to change, but you feel connected to this old version. And you start to think, what will this person think of me? What would this person say? And it's very difficult to break out of that. And it's very normal to feel that way, because ultimately we want to be connected to other people. We want to be liked and we want to be in communities. And so if we believe that a possible action or a possible change in who we are or our life is going to influence that, it keeps us stuck. It keeps us safe and it keeps us comfortable. But you know There's something more that you want and you want to change your life. It's about changing your identity. And so now we get on to the big old question, how the hell do you change your identity? And there's a combination of two that I like to use. So we just mentioned that your beliefs drive your behavior and your actions, which ultimately create the results in your life. But it's going to be a combination of shifting your beliefs and changing your actions to match those beliefs. Because if we act in a certain way and we start to see evidence, that's going to also increase the belief. So it's a combination of doing the internal work, shifting your beliefs now, and taking small actions of the person you want to become. So maybe there's certain people in different areas of your life that you look up to, that you admire. They have certain traits, they have certain results or things about them that you would like to adopt. It's worth taking some time to study those people and see what those things are. The other important factor, which I didn't mention, which will really, really keep you stuck, is the internal stuff. That's the I'm the type of person who, or I'm not the type of person who does this. And I can use health and fitness for an example here, because this is something I've seen numerous times when I've been working with clients in this space. And I'm very careful listening to the language that clients and people use, and even in conversations where people have been asking me for advice before. And it's that internal language and the words that are communicated in the external world where there's a story. It's, I want to do this, but, or I'm the type of person who. Now, if you want to change your identity, that I'm the type of person who is very important. So let's say, for example, it's in the health and fitness space. You want to lose 25 pounds of body fat and you don't identify as a person who works out. It's going to seem like work at start, but it's the daily actions and the habits that stack up over time. And every time you take a positive action, you incorporate a new habit. You can see that as a little vote so that you're voting to become the type of person who would. And then whatever your goal is, you want to support that and build that up by actually taking the actions. So it's a combination of the internal work, shifting the beliefs, overcoming the self-limitations, the self-sabotaging thoughts, the old conditioning, reprogramming the subconscious mind, alongside the practical actionable steps, which involves self-discipline, making small wins, small actions that are going to build up and support the belief that you're trying to create. And over time, when these are combined, you're going to create that new identity, that new version of yourself. Obviously, you want to be surrounded with people that are going where you want to go, people that are supporting you and on the right track, because your environment is going to be a key factor in this. Now, if you're currently in a place where you feel stuck, you're in a lot of pain and you desperately want to change some aspect or multiple aspects or results in your life, it's not a bad thing because you can use that pain as your fuel to change. You know, if I think back now to when I was younger, there were certain times in my life where I was really struggling, but I desperately wanted to change. And what I realized over the years of doing that, transforming my body, transforming my mind, moving to a new country, starting my own business, feeling way better about myself, attracting the perfect relationship for me. All of these things happened because I shifted who I was as a person. Because in life, we don't get what we want. We get who we are. We have to be in alignment. We have to match up with that internally, our self-image, our vibration, our alignment of who we want to become. And when you can start to shift the internal work and you can support that with the actions moving forwards, the habits, little by little, you're going to change your self-image. You're going to change your identity. And ultimately, you're going to be living a completely different life. So if you're looking for a starting point, it's going to be overcoming your self-limiting beliefs. So you want to watch this video here to do that. If you have any questions, leave them below. I'd love for you to let me know what identity you're trying to create, the type of person you're looking to become. Let me know in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.